A lot to get to here. Let's bring in defense attorney Sarah Azari joining us now. Sarah, good to see you again. So let's listen to Michael Avenatti as he took to the mic yesterday. Then we'll get your take coming out. Here he is.
Sure.
As all of you know, for the entirety of my career, I have fought against the powerful, powerful people and powerful corporations. I will never stop fighting that good fight.
So there you go. He's ready to fight. What do you think of the two cases against him?
Look, Mike, the extortion case out of the Southern District of New York, obviously the question there is this an ethical violation where perhaps he crossed the line by being an overly zealous and aggressive lawyer on behalf of his client, or is this a shakedown, which under the law is extortion? I think the problem he has in that case is when you look at some of the evidence as alleged in the charging document and the complaint, it appears that he wasn't just advocating on behalf of the client with the bad information about Nike employees, but he was also demanding something like $22.5 million for himself and co-conspirator number one being Mark Garagos, for an internal investigation that was not solicited by Nike. Nike has in-house counsel, outside counsel. They never asked for an internal investigation, and yet I think Avenatti's demand was that if you don't pay the sum, and by the way, this sum is paid and deemed earned upon receipt. We're not going to bill against it on an hourly basis, which is what most lawyers like us do. It starts to look coercive. Nike was given a couple of days to basically comply with this demand or else. So once it starts to look more and more coercive and less about the client and more about the lawyers, it starts to look more like extortion for Michael Avenatti. Of course, Garagos has not been charged. Michael Avenatti is presumed innocent until these charges are proven guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. He's facing up to 80 years in federal prison if found guilty on all those counts in the extortion case. But Mike, I think the more problematic case for Avenatti is the one in my jurisdiction, the Central District of California, where he's charged with wire fraud for embezzling settlement monies from a client, and also with bank fraud. I think that of all of these counts pending against him, the bank fraud case is the most problematic and most difficult to beat because it involves allegations of falsifying tax returns for years in which Avenatti has allegedly not filed tax returns and presenting those to a federally insured bank to get a $4.1 million bank loan. Paper cases are very, very difficult to beat. And you know, I just want to say this, you know, Avenatti, we've gotten to know him over the last year or so as the fighter, as the advocate, the R. Kelly tapes for the victim, Stormy Daniels, anti-Trump. You know, one point his Twitter was had the hashtag Fight Club all over it. And I think it's now time for Michael Avenatti to fight for himself, his liberty, his reputation, his freedom, and frankly, his bar license on both coasts.